Hey, welcome back to the Mr. Excel Netcast. I'm Bill Jelen.
Basically, you start out with massive amounts of data. You say, how are we going to analyze this? Well, let's fire up a pivot table and see if we can solve this problem.
Welcome back to the Mr. Excel Netcast. I'm Bill Jelen. Yesterday, I went through this big, long hassle because I was going to solve the pivot table problem using a recorded macro. That's where every time we created the pivot table, we had to go into pivot table options and change the name to a specific name. Now, I did that because I wanted the macro to work with the macro recorder. If you're not afraid to switch over into VBA and do a little bit of coding to change that recorded macro, we can avoid that whole hassle. Here's what I'm going to do. Alt F11 to go over and take a look. Here in the Project Explorer, we double-click on modules, double-click on Module 1. We get to see the recorded code. Now, I'm going to add a few lines of code here to the top. First line of code, dim, PT, that's a variable, as pivot table, and then I'm going to say set PT equal to active sheet dot pivot tables with an S 1. And what that's going to do is it's going to set up a variable called PT, which refers to the first pivot table on the sheet. In the example, I'm assuming that we only have one pivot table per sheet, so that's going to work out fine. And then everywhere where the recorded macro refers to active sheet dot pivot tables bill PT, I can simply put in PT. So we'll go through here. It looks like there are two of them. PT. And now we have a nice generic macro that will always work with the first pivot table on the sheet. We never have to go through and rename the sheets, not even before we record the macro. So let's try it here. Data, pivot table, finish. I'll put region along the left hand side and then maybe date next. Finally, revenue, profit, and cost of goods sold, going across. Okay, so now we can run that macro. Alt F8 to get a list of macros, format my pivot, click run, and when we go down to see the break between west and central, it successfully formatted that pivot table. So, just a tiny bit of coding, basically one, two lines that I had to type, and then change the hard-coded pivot table names to refer to that variable. Great way to make this very generic macro. Hey, I want to thank you for stopping by. Of course, you know, if you want to learn about VBA, I have a couple of products. The Live Lessons Power Macros for Excel, or even the books VBA and Macros for Microsoft Excel, both designed to get you up to speed from recording macros to being able to generalize your macros with these few lines of code to make things much more powerful. All right, hey, I want to thank you for stopping by. We'll see you next time for another Netcast from Mr. Excel.
Thanks for stopping by. We'll see you next time for another Netcast from Mr. Excel.